Read. So today we're going to start with that, okay? Yes, I remember that I told you in the first, that you're going to make that in the first hour, in the beginning of the class, right? Okay, so let me see. Yes, I have the names over here, I guess. Sailin, Brenda, and Hans, right? Les falta leer. Leer o decir lo que en todo caso hablaron with your friends about the classroom rules, okay? So let's start with Sailin. Sailin, are you ready? You're gonna share a screen, yes. Sailin, o alguien va a comprar partir por ahí pantalla contigo?
Yo, Luciana. Me espera un ratito por ti.
That's okay, gotta help Luciana. Okay, Luciana, it's ready, okay? I give you the option to share. It's ready there. Te doy la opción de compartir.
Okay.
Come on, ready?
Sí, miss. ¿Lo puede ver?
Yes, thank you. Ah, you put pictures. That's good. Thank you, Luciana. Good job. Okay, Sailin.
Okay. Pasa la siguiente diapositiva, Luciana. Okay. Respect our classmates. Brenda teacher went and read the class. Turn off the microphone so I no cause noise in the virtual classes. Respect the opinion of under. Come to class time.
Okay, thank you. Don't take it off the screen. Espérate, no todavía no lo saques. Okay, don't take it off. Very good, Sailin. Very good, all the group. And I'm gonna congratulate to this group, okay? Because, miren, de lo sencillo, ellos han hecho algo de repente un poco más elaborado, and that's good, that's good. And congratulate that. Very good, guys. Very good that you stay. Everybody in the group, okay? So, something that I can choose from here is, for example, respect opinions of others. Yes, it's necessary to respect opinions, not only for the teacher, it's for the rest of the classmates, okay? Y esto de aquí lo podemos también, porque más que opiniones, porque a veces no damos muchas opinions in English, right? Pero sí participamos bastante en our pronunciation, o de repente por ahí, nos quedamos en blanco, ¿no? Oh, how do you say that in English, ¿no? Puede pasar. So yo lo que más que todo voy a pedir, respectful for your friends, when they participate, okay? Sobre todo no burlarnos, no hacer caras ahí, o no sé, expresiones que pueden incomodar your classmates, tus amigos, your classmates, okay? Thank you, this group, very good, good
buenos job. Días, very good. Buenos días, miss.
Good morning, yes, Gallery. Yes. Gallery, you are.
¿Ya dejó de compartir?
Yes, Luciana, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Flags for you, okay, very good. Okay, so let's continue. Gallery, si estás, ¿no? En segundo, tú eres en segundo secundario, ¿no, Gallery?
Sí, miss.
Oh, okay, honey, thank you so much. Okay, let's continue with Brenda. Brenda?
Sí, okay,
Brenda, you're welcome.
Va a compartir a Camila, mi grupo.
Okay, sí, Camila. Okay, remember, compartir, share. Camila va a share, donde sea así, ¿no? Poquito a poquito. Okay, that's good. Another beautiful PowerPoint over there. Very good, girls. Qué bonita esta aula. Okay, come on.
Comienzo mi.
Yes, Brenda, go ahead.
Okay, miss. Rules of school. Be in a class on time. Who chat only for important things. Be silent when your colleagues are participating. Pay attention to class. Raise your hand to participate. Turn on the microphone. Microphone only when the teacher allows it. Y attend class uniform and presenter.
Okay, thank you, Brenda. Thank you so much. That's a nice PowerPoint. Very good. Congratulations to all the group, okay? Very good. And something here that I can take it off is this one, right? Use chat only for important things. If you have an emergency, Miss, I need to go to the bathroom very quickly. Okay. No aguanto, Miss, please. Okay. Send me a message. No abres el micrófono para decirme, Miss, ve, go to the bathroom porque interrumpimos ahí la clase. Okay. Try to do it in English. Trata de hacerlo en inglés también cuando escribas. Okay. We use the chat también a veces para algunas actividades. Hoy día vamos a hacer an activity y vamos a usar el chat solo cuando yo lo requiero. Okay. Very good, this group. Good job. Congratulations, everybody in the group. Very good. Okay, can you take it off the screen, please? Ahora sí pueden sacar. That's good. Perfect, perfect. Okay. Hans. Where is Hans? ¿No está Hans? ¿No ha entrado Hans? Tenía que. ¿Alguien de su grupo quiera reemplazar a Hans? Alguien de su grupo que quiera leer, porque ya tiene, no sé, ya tengo. Miss, yo tengo la diapositiva de mi grupo. Lo voy a leer.
¿Voy compartiendo el trabajo?
Ok, John, y please, hazte cargo en todo caso, porque Hans no está. Va a quedar mal todo tu grupo. ¿Qué te parece si tú compartes y lo lees? ¿Yes?
Ya me sale del trabajo. Pero, ¿yo tengo que exponerlo o alguien del grupo?
You can do it. Can you do it? ¿Tú puedes hacerlo? Es que iba a hacerlo Hans, pero no está.
Ya me está bien.
¿Puedes hacerlo? Okay. Thank you, John. Okay, go ahead.
Rules in the classroom. Raise your hand to say, attend properly uniformed, attend virtual classes on time, respect our classmates and teachers, keep the microphone off, deliver the words on the indicated date. Use the Zoom chat only to comment on the class. When entering class, we must greet the teacher. Be in a comfortable space before class begins. Pay attention to classes without being distracted.
Very good. Thank you very much, John. Thank you. Don't take it off. I'm going to read. Voy a leer una que otra. Please, can you share again, please?
Okay, Miss Pepe. Entonces pongo el papel, Miss.
Yes, please. Okay, first, to tell you congratulations because you elaborate, all the group elaborate PowerPoint. Chicos, sus PowerPoints son mejor que los míos, pero okay, that's good, very good. And let me take it off one with this one. Okay, deliver the words on the indicated time. Okay, so you have to present your words on time. For example, today, ¿no? Hoy hemos tenido una actividad. Yo ahí ya les voy a dar algún punto por ahí adicional por lo que han hecho hoy día. Okay, but you have to be on time. You have to present on time. No, no lo hicimos the next class. No, ¿eh? No hay opportunities. It's in the time, en el momento que la misa especifica, and that's it. Okay. Very good class. Congratulations to everybody. And that was all the groups. Esos fueron todos los grupos que nos faltaban. Okay, let's go to... Okay. Today we have a class. Acuérdense que esta semana estamos trabajando everything about introductions, ¿no? Todo lo que tenga que ver con introducción a cosas que vamos a manejar durante el año. Like greetings, like classroom, rules classrooms, right, que hemos visto. And the date. La fecha es algo que nosotros vamos a manejar every day, todos los días que nos conectemos, right? So it's necessary to know how to write the date and what does mean también. ¿Cómo escribo? ¿Qué escribo en la fecha? En el easy, okay? So for that reason, first, okay, what the day today? We need to know the days of the week, the ordinal numbers, and the months of the year and seasons. Well, the seasons is algo extra, ¿no? Porque en realidad, de alguna otra forma, no nos ayuda para las fechas. Okay, so the days of the week, the ordinal numbers, the months of the years, and seasons. Let's start with the days of the week. Okay, so gallery, please open your microphone. Gallery, do you remember the days of the week? ¿Sabes los days of the week? Yes? Okay.
Demi. So,
los días de la semana en English. So, acuérdate, Gallery, y en everybody, todos, que empezamos los días de la semana con domingo en inglés, ¿ok? Sunday es domingo, Sunday, y luego continúas con el resto de días. No empezamos con lunes como en Spanish. Sunday con domingo. Ok, Gallery, come on. Sunday, what else? You don't remember? No? Okay, that's okay, Gallery. Repeat after me, okay? Sunday. Come on, Gallery. Monday. Sunday.
Monday.
Monday. Monday. Tuesday. Wednesday. Thursday. Friday.
Thursday.
And Saturday. Okay, Gallery. Okay, okay. So, homework for everybody, no solo por Gallery. Van a memorizar, you're going to memorize the days of the week. ¿Ah? O sea, que quiere decir que la próxima vez que yo te pregunte a cualquiera de ustedes, ya está aquí in your head. Okay, so everybody, sin abrir el microphone, repeat after me. It's necessary to have a good pronunciation. So, let's emphasize. Okay, let's emphasize. Thank you, Luana. The pronunciation of the days, okay? So let me see. Repeat after me, please. Sin abrir el micrófono. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, okay? Well, I guess it is clear until there. Let's continue now with ordinal numbers. No, let me call somebody else. Camila Pascual. Camila Pascual, what in Spanish, what is the ordinal numbers? In Spanish, what is the ordinal numbers?
Orden, primero, segundo, tercero.
Yes, that's right. Thank you, Yamila. That's good. Well, in English, we say, very good, Camila. Boom, dos puntos ahí, that's good, okay. In English, we say the first, primero, right? The first, the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, the eighth, seventh, the eighth, sorry, the ninth, and the tenth, okay? So, why, Miss, is important the ordinal numbers for dates? ¿Para qué? ¿Para qué en fechas? Okay, look at that. S-T-N-D. Okay. R-D, R-D. Mira cómo termina. T-H. Okay, my friend. Estas letritas que ves aquí son aquellas que se ponen en el número de la fecha. Acuérdate que cuando tú escribes la fecha, escribes el número y le pones al lado del número una abreviación. Siempre son dos letritas, ¿no? Que puede ser ST, ND, RD, TH, ¿ok? Eso va chiquitito en la parte de arriba, no va grandote al lado del número, va chiquitito. Solo que nosotros a veces aquí en la pantalla se nos hace bien difícil tipearlo, ¿no? El pequeñito, pero va pequeñito, ¿ok? So, eso quiere decir que todos los primeros de cada mes, the first day of the month, si yo tengo, si es primero de marzo, voy a tener que poner ST, ST. The second day of the month, ND. The third day of the month, RD. Y después, a partir del 8, hacia adelante, TH, TH, ¿no? Porque todos terminan, miren, con TH, you see? TH, TH, ¿ok? O sea que tiene una razón las letritas. No las pongo de decoración. No. They have a reason. Tiene una razón. Depende del number que vayas a utilizar en la fecha. You use the abbreviation. Ok. So let's see. Miss. O sea que just 1, 2, 3 chain, right? 1 FD. 2 ND. 3 RD. And then 4, 5, 6 and is always TH. Siempre es TH. No. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, for 11, yes, it's TH because it's the 11th. Okay, for 12, yes, TH. For 13, TH. For 14, TH. TH. For 20, or 20, sorry, is TH. That's okay. 30, yes, TH, no? Aquí les he puesto un extra, 60, the 60 TH. Es un extra porque no hay ningún mes que tenga 50 días. Es un extra. ¿Ok? Ok, mis, o sea que siempre es TH. Del 4 hacia adelante. No, exactly. Look at that. Ok, you have here on a square. Ok, look at that. Miren, así es como se coloca. The number and the abbreviation. Look at the abbreviation. The abbreviation is small, little, pequeñito, short, ok, chiquito, no va del tamaño del number. Ok, so it's first, aquí está como te he dicho, first is C, second in D, third are D, and then four, HT, ok, and H, TH, 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 all the numbers TH. But look at that, 21. FT again, 22, ND, 23, RD, okay? And then TH, 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 until 31, that is ST, okay? Esas son las abreviaciones que tienen que ir en mi fecha, okay? So, remember, cuidado con el 1, 2, 3, con el 21, con el 22, con el 23 y con el 31. Lo demás siempre va a ser TH. You have homework también. Memorízate esto. Ahora, mi, se me hace complicado todavía. Ok, imprímelo, porque yo te lo voy a mandar esto, va a estar en el CIE web. Ok, puedes imprimir este PowerPoint y lo pegas ahí en un lugar cerca a tu casa para que no te olvides how to write the date, ¿no? Cómo poner la fecha. And what else? Y practicas, okay, to practice. Okay, any question until here? Any question or is clear? The ordinal numbers is clear. Any question? No, right? Okay, so we have been working days of the week, ordinal numbers. Let's continue with the next one. The months of the year, okay? Look at that, the months of the year. Let's see all the months. Okay, so pay attention to the pronunciation because it's necessary to have or to know the right pronunciation, okay? Así que para eso vas a escuchar the first pronunciation for the first month, el primer mes. Okay, listen. Wait a minute, chicos. Okay, wait a minute there, okay? So what are you gonna do is to listen, and I'm gonna reproduce the song from Cambridge Dictionary. If you wanna look any meaning, quieres buscar el significado, the pronunciation in American and British pronunciation, o sea, tienes dos pronunciaciones ahí, use the Cambridge Dictionary, okay? So I guess that is the best dictionaries can help you to learn English. Okay, so let's listen the pronunciation for the first month. Listen, please.
January.
January. No es January, 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 no.
January.
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 January. Okay?
January.
January. Ok, yo me imagino que ustedes están ahí practicando, ¿no? Porque no los veo, bueno, no hay problema, no, don't open your webcam now, pero practica, por favor, after the song, ok?
January.
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 January. Ok, let's see the next month.
February. February.
February. February, but fast. February.
February. February.
February.
February.
February. Okay, very good. And I guess that the other months, los otros son easy, no? A little more easy, or easier, sorry, easier, más fácil to pronounce. There is another one que siempre tenemos controversia. Let me show you. Agosto. ¿Cómo se dice o cómo se pronuncia ghost in English? Miss August. August. Ok, listen.
August.
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 August. That's the pronunciation. August.
August.
August. Ok. One more time.
August.
August. Ok. So let me see. Let me go. So, everybody, repeat after me, okay? Without, no, don't open your microphone, just repeat at home to know the real pronunciation, okay? January, January, February, 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 March, 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 April, 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 May, no Maya, May, 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 June, June, June. Okay, that's July, July, not Julie, Julie is your best friend, I don't know. July, 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 July. And you remember this one? Agat. Agates, sorry. Agates. Agates. Okay. And then September, 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 October, October, November, November, and December, no December, eh? December, December, December. Okay. And that's all the months. So we have the seasons over there, do you see? For example, summer, that is December, January, February, summer, right? And then we have the spring, September, October, November, autumn or fall, no, otoño or fall, March, April, May, and winter is June, July, and August, okay? So very good. So now I want to listen your pronunciation. I'm going to call some of you to read, okay? Alessandro. Alessandro. Hello. Cuando los llame, abra su cámara, please, okay? No solamente su audio, sino también su webcam, okay? Okay, Alessandro, read please the months for, okay, read the months for summer. Read.
Elijo Alessandro, uno.
No, no, read, lee, read all the months in summer, todos los meses de verano, summer, read, please.
December, January, y a mí no me acuerdo el febrero.
Millo puede ser.
Un ratito, Brenda. Ok, Alessandro, consejo, ok, abre tu cámara, Alessandro, hay quien sigue. Consejo, en su blog que ustedes manejan o su cuaderno de inglés extra que tengan ahí, porque yo no pido ni un material, tú ves qué material usas, ¿ok? Una hojita, un blog, hojitas se pierden, ¿no? Yo te recomiendo un blog o un notebook que se comenzaba o algo así, ¿ok? So, la próxima vez que trabajemos pronunciation, Alessandro, copia, como tú lo escuchas, copia la palabra ahí, ¿right? For example, January, February, December, ok, copy that, para que así cuando tú estés solo, tu tarea, ¿cuál va a ser? Ir al espejo y vas a estar así, January, February, ok, because it's necessary, chicos, you have to practice the pronunciation, it's the only way to learn, ok, Alexandro, so the next time there is an excuse, ¿eh? Porque yo he estado haciendo la pronunciación, ok, Brenda, come on, read the month of summer.
Okay,
miss. Read the month.
Leon, miss.
Yes.
Okay. December, January, February.
Okay. January, February, February. Okay. Very good, Brenda. Thank you so much. Okay. Let me see. Francisco Lizarbe. Oh, Francesco, I'm sorry. Francesco. Well, in Spanish is Francisco. Okay, Francesco, come on. Open your webcam and your microphone. Read the months for from autumn. Okay? Read the months from autumn. Come on, Francesco.
March, April, May.
No escuché nada. Escuché March y de ahí May. Pero yo veo tres aquí, 3 months. One more time, Francesco. Come on. Francesco.
March, April y May.
Okay, March, April, April, May. Chicos, please, el próximo que le pregunte y no me pronuncie adecuadamente, voy a dar por aludido que mi garganta me duele, ¿ah? Porque yo estoy acá, repite, repite, cuando tú abres el micro, you say another thing. Ok, please,
yo Francesco, le puedo decir.
Ok, Davis, come on, read the autumn pronunciation, the autumn months.
Me... No, a mí, yo le quería decir este spring, miss.
Ok, you want to continue. Ok, go to spring.
September, October y November.
Ya, Davis, pero ahí hubo trampita porque tú elegiste esquea. But that's okay, Davis. Thank you to participate anyway. Okay, let me see the next one. Daniela del Carmen. Daniela del Carmen. Okay, and your webcam, please. Your webcam. Okay, Daniela, please read the winter months.
Okay. June. Almost jelly.
Okay, okay. Daniela, listen to me. June, June. Ahí copia. June, July, July. And the other one is August. August, August. Okay. A ver, Daniela, come on. Tú ahora.
Jelly. August.
No. No, Daniela, one more time after me, okay? Ya, después de mí, Daniela. June.
June.
July.
July.
August.
August.
August. Ahora, Daniela, the same one, ¿eh? Toma apuntes. Apunta cómo lo pronuncio para que tú lo practiques, okay? Ok, very good, everybody. Bueno, chicos, ya es responsabilidad de cada uno también, ok? So, let's continue. Let's gonna write the day now, ok? Write the date. Ok, let me see. Let me share with you my board. Let me share my board. And I'm gonna write the day for today. A ver, la fecha de hoy día, for today. Today is our favorite day, Friday. Ok, Friday. And what is the month? March, okay, March, okay, no, no comment, March. What is the number? The number is 19. ¿Y qué dice mi regla de los ordinal numbers? Que cuando es 19 utilizo the TH, right? TH. Okay, comma 2021, okay? Amigo, escribe esta fecha en tu cuaderno, en tu blog, en your paper, in whatever place, ¿ok? Why? Porque esta estructura es la que vamos a utilizar para poner nuestras fechas de aquí para adelante, ¿ok? Ah, me estaba olvidando algo really important. All the days, all the months, todos los días de la semana, todos los días del mes, van with capital letters, con mayúsculas. Nunca se escriben con minúsculas. Ni siquiera en los textos, ¿ah? No solamente en las fechas, sino en los textos. Siempre van a ir con capital letters, all the time, ¿ok? So, look at my example, porque tú vas a hacer ahorita un ejercicio conmigo. Look at my example. Ok, look at my example, what are you going to do? Write the date, mira las comas, where is the commas are. Ok, look at the capital letters.
Una pregunta, ¿vamos a usar el libro?
Not today, not today. No hoy día. Okay, so look at, okay, look at the capital letters, look at the commas, look at the year, look at the order, everything, okay? You have to do the same. Okay, let me see. We don't have, no tenemos más tiempito ahorita en este Zoom, así que para poder hacer the next exercise, voy a cerrar el Zoom y volvemos a ingresar, okay, chicos, para que no nos quedemos en la mitad de la actividad. Okay, see you the next Zoom. No he tomado lista, así que come back. See you the next Zoom.